So try following that act. That was great. Thank you, Greg. You are terribly inspiring. Rabbi Wein, Tamara, the rest of you. Distinguished guests, Institute faculty, colleagues, family, friends, my wonderful two communities, Oraynu and Adat Chavirim. On April the 10th, 2004, my beloved mother, Gitl Mezei, drew her last breath. Yet even if she were alive today, she would not be sitting here, quelling with nachas at her daughter's ordination. My mother was a devout Hasidic Jew who condoned neither secular humanistic Judaism nor women's ordination. To her, they were a desecration of Torah true Judaism. But my mother taught me to live a life of integrity. Hasidic Judaism was becoming inconsistent with my burgeoning feminism and my insatiable desire for knowledge and learning, considered a male domain. So I abandoned Hasidism forever, and with it the hope of parental approval and the loving embrace of my family and community of origin. Well, you can leave Hasidut, but it doesn't leave you. The sages and Hasidic rabbis taught that one must always approach God, the sovereign master, Begilur Adah, with joy and trembling. God is no longer meaningful or relevant in my life, but I still approach significant and transformative moments with joy and trembling. This is one of those moments, and I feel incredibly privileged to be sharing it with all of you. 19 years ago, I first entered this building to participate in the historic formation of the International Federation of Secular and Humanistic Jews. For me, it was what the great German Jewish poet Paul Celan would have called a joyous homecoming. Then in 1991, at what I thought was the first colloquium, I stood here before many of you to celebrate my graduation and ordination as a madricha. By then I had already chosen my life's work to help build and perpetuate secular humanistic Judaism, and through its expression, to enable people to create comforting, meaningful, and impactful Jewish lives. My mother would not have appreciated the irony, but it is because of her that I'm standing here today. On October the 19th, 2000, I turned 50, and it hit me like a bolt of lightning. I imagine the ancient prophets would have called that divine revelation. I realized that my mother was only 62 years old when she began to exhibit the debilitating symptoms of Alzheimer's. Since there was possibly a hereditary factor in this disease, it occurred to me that the sand might run out of my timer sooner than I had hoped, and that I had better use my brain while I still could. No doubt I also felt that as my mother lost her cognitive abilities, I needed to know and remember for both of us. It was then that I decided to return and fulfill a dream that had been hunkering in me for years, to return to university and to complete a graduate degree either in psychology to enhance my psychotherapy practice or in Jewish studies to further my goals within this movement. Well, looking back over the past 4 years, I can honestly say, wow, what a ride it's been. What an unbelievable ride it's been. With plenty of joy and trembling, I completed 118 credits, researched and wrote dozens of academic papers and 2 graduate theses. I earned 3 degrees. To steal a line from my friend Ed Klein, Ed, where are you? I learn by degrees. So all of this I accomplished while working more than full time, supporting a family, and volunteering at all levels of this movement. I wore out my friends just telling them what I was doing. So today I can also say, phew, I am relieved that this leg of my journey has finally come to an end. I will talk about my future journey, but first I want to show my appreciation to all who made the trip this far possible. If I stand tall today or can see further, does that sound familiar? It is because I, too, stand on the shoulder of giants. Sherwin, thank you for creating all of this and for being a remarkable teacher, mentor, and friend. None of us would be here today if not for you. I'm also grateful to all individuals and organizations who generously support the Institute and all its programs. You have enabled our vision to take flight. Thanks also to my amazing, sometimes mind-blowing professors, both here and at Hebrew College in Boston. And last but not least, a debt of gratitude to my spectacular daughters, Jody, Corey, to my friends and soulmates, Miriam, Karen, Margie, my other dearest friends, many of whom are here today, to my congregation who turned out in huge numbers, and to my future congregation, Adat Chavirim. I could not have done it without your love, your wisdom, your support, and encouragement. Yashar Koach. Now, although this exhilarating ride is over, and I joyfully celebrate it with all of you, this is also a commencement. As I begin the next leg of my journey, I tremble with excitement and anticipation, and a touch of trepidation, at the overwhelming task that awaits me as a humanist rabbi in this movement. All my life, I've lived with a tape in my head, because you can, you must. So I've worked tirelessly, okay, I admit, neurotically, to help, to change things for the better, to make a difference. Well, I turned 55 a few days ago, and I had another epiphany. I finally accepted the wisdom of Rabbi Tarfon, who said in Mishnei Avot, Lo alecha hamlacha ligmor, velo ata ven chorin, libatel mimena. You are not obligated to complete the task, but neither are you at liberty to desist therefrom. How amazingly liberating and invigorating this teaching is for the neurotic in me. I share with most of you the dream of seeing secular and humanistic Jewish communities and congregations flourish all over the world, and that it will be a bessere und schönere Welt, a better and more beautiful world. I expect to contribute to the realization of this dream, but I no longer feel that I have to do it all or that I have to do it alone. We're all in this together. I will instead focus my passion and my energies in 2 specific areas. I will strive to mitigate Jewish interdenominational friction, beginning with the secular humanist divide, and to significantly increase Jewish literacy among humanistic Jewish adults. For the first cause, I'm inspired by Yehuda Amichai's poem, המקום שבו אנו צודקים, the place where we are right, he wrote. From the place where we are right, flowers will never grow in spring. The place where we are right is trampled and hard like a paved courtyard. But doubts and love make the world into loosened soil like a mole, like a plow. Then a whisper can be heard in the place where the temple that was destroyed once stood. As a child, I was taught that the temple in Jerusalem was destroyed because of sinat chinam, baseless, internecine hatred among the Jews. Since then, I have always believed that we can disagree with each other and choose very different life paths, yet remain accepting and respectful towards one another. Nature is magnificent in all its diversity. So can we be. Competitiveness and disrespect among Jews discourage many from participating in Jewish organizational life. I'm convinced that when we join hands in the communion of struggle and work together to spread our important message to many Jews who hunger for a Jewish life of integrity in our contemporary societies, that we will grow and we will flourish. Secular humanistic Judaism, or Jewishness, in all its rich ideological and structural varieties, will grow dramatically. Through Adat Chavarim, my new congregation in Los Angeles, which I am really joyously looking forward to serving in the years to come, I am beginning the process of building bridges among the secular and humanistic communities, as well as with the larger LA Jewish community. Regarding our place in the larger Jewish community, I believe there is unity in diversity. Instead of cutting ourselves off because we believe and behave differently from many other Jews, we must say, Hineni, here I am, to the call for one united Am Yisrael. I am convinced that our confident, respectful, and consistent presence within the larger Jewish community, while retaining our secular and humanistic values and behavior, will result in a cessation of our marginalization by other Jewish movements. Then, secular humanistic Judaism will become fully integrated into the larger Jewish community, and as I said, it will flourish. The Yiddish poet Chaim Grada wrote, "Alone it is good to weep upon graves, but to a goal people must go together." Imagine with me, if you will, the harmonious world of increasing justice and peace that we can build together. I am convinced that it is no dream. If we focus our energies in concert, we can make it a reality. I also tremble with excitement and hope as I contemplate my second task. I am convinced, tonight I'm convinced a lot, that Jewish seeing you makes me convinced that Jewish community depends on Jewish self-esteem. If it doesn't feel good to be Jewish, then why bother? Wherever I see high levels of Jewish knowledge coupled with integrity of belief and behavior, I see committed Jews of all denominations who perpetuate their knowledge and love for Judaism to their children and to others. We don't all need to become Jewish scholars, but I believe that secular humanistic Jews need to get a more solid grounding in Jewish history, philosophy, and literature, from classical to contemporary. We need to acquire a basic working understanding of halakha, or rabbinic Jewish law. And very importantly, we need to have a fairly comprehensive understanding of the Jewish calendar and the rhythm of Jewish life across time and across the denominational spectrum. many secular and humanistic Jews are only marginally engaged in Jewish life. It is my contention that when we become more Jewishly literate while retaining our engagement with the secular world, our confidence and sense of Jewish legitimacy will increase dramatically. I am convinced that this will result in strongly committed secular humanistic Jews who will ensure the continuity of secular humanistic Judaism for future generations. On Pesach 5764, in Nisan, the month of liberation, my beloved mother was finally liberated from her struggle with Alzheimer's. Although her worldview was different from mine, it was her abiding love of people, her strong ethical foundation, and her sincere love of Judaism, all of which she passed on to me, that forged the committed humanistic Jew that I am today. You are now my family and community. I am committed to working on your behalf and for this movement to increase the level of acceptance and respect among ourselves and between different denominations. I am also committed to bringing us together to build a better world for everyone, a world in which we care about our planet and for all living things, especially each other. Finally, I'm committed to creating resources to enhance the education for our communities and to actively sharing what I know and what I will continue to learn in the years to come. Herzl said, "If you will it, it is no dream." Join me in this task of building and being built. Together, let us make our dreams for secular humanistic Judaism and our world a reality. Toda. Thank you.